An interesting piece of anthropological biology is the propagation of the lactose processing enzyme LCT, which is responsible for the body's processing of sugars derived from milk. The gene that produces LCT is inherent in every mammal, but the production of the enzyme is a temporary affair in most creatures carrying it. If one observes the attached map, one can see that some cultures are entirely disposed to digesting dairy, while others are almost entirely lactose intolerant after infancy. The primary reason for this disparity is the presence and usage of dairy animals, presenting gene groups with prolific historic use of bovine milk being evident in North Europeans, Middle Easterners and North Africans, and African pastoralists, and India. Because of the long exposure and usage of dairy cows, these genetic types have been permanently disposed towards lactose tolerance, meaning their bodies never stop producing the LCT enzyme. During infancy, children actively support the LCT lactose processing mechanism, and over time, unless this mechanism is continuously stimulated, the body will slowly lose the ability to process milk. That is, without proactive and continuous support for a temporary biological mechanism, the body can and will cut support for it, in the same manner in which a car manufacturer stops carrying spare parts for old models. Hopefully, parallel between the LCT enzyme and democracy isn't lost. In the same manner in which the natural state of humanity post-infancy is lactose intolerance, so too is the natural state of humanity's paternalistic tyranny. How is it that of all societies to have ever existed, that the majority of all of them have been, from the Enlightenment point of view, tyrannies? There wasn't some illiberal demiurge goading the first civilizations towards the reign of god kings, but with almost mathematical certainty, once civilizations attain a point of development, they will naturally form despotism. This despotism can be seen on multiple levels, as both stateless and state societies have been subject to this. Primitive societies have existed in a state of despotism by authority or by majority, be it the shaman, chief, or tribal council. The only decisions in a tribe made by popular sovereignty is the decision to leave the tribe. The Enlightenment democracies as they exist are a lightning in a bottle event, and I do not see such a thing returning assuming it has been lost. Look today at every nation besides Western Europe which has developed a democracy. Although the vast majority of the world's countries are democracies, nobody speaks in particular of the propensity and strength of the Paraguayan democracy, or the virtue of Armenian elections. When grading democracy, a more accurate phraseology would be virtuous, illiberal, or failed democracies. I posit that in actuality, it is only a small percentage of countries which can actually be called virtuous, as the United States is not one of them. Even in free liberal westernized nations such as Japan, South Korea, or Taiwan, actual democracy is hard to find. It has often been said that post-war Japan has been a one-party state, and this is not entirely false. Uninterrupted for the last 70 years in Japan, the paradoxically named Liberal Democratic Conservative Party has been the uncontested dominant party in Japan. Japanese elections are almost entirely a sham, and the actual campaign season for these elections is about 3 weeks. In the United States, the campaign season starts over a year in advance of the election, but the Japanese are somehow able to pull it off in less than a month. This system, by nature, favors the incumbent party. Public political ads are virtually outlawed outside of a select time window, and many Japanese are hardly aware of the platforms or personages of the minority parties because of their lack of exposure, and state-mandated silence before the election window. Despite Japan being for all intents and purposes a single-party state, it has rates noticeably higher than the United States in terms of democratic adherence. The United States is quickly slipping, and is no longer considered a virtuous working democracy, leaving it in the same nepotistic categories as the plutocracies of Tunisia and South Africa. The United States, a bastion of democracy, is quickly slipping into corruption. Like the LCT gene, democracy needs to be stimulated, it needs to be supported. If it's not upheld, it will wither and be lost. The refusal of the United States to remove moneyed interest in its politics is the same as starving the LCT gene for reasons to exist post-infancy. The ultimate question is going to be whether the United States gets out of its corrupt fugue state or develops into democratic intolerance. There are few actual democracies on Earth, and history will judge us harshly if we fail.